This morning in Living Healthy, we're talking about your health when it comes to fertility. And since it's National Infertility Awareness Week, Dr. Alison Zimon and Dr. Kerri Luzzo are here from IVF New England and the Providence Fertility Center. Mm-hmm. Thanks for being here.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
Okay, Dr. Luzzo, let's start with you. How do you know if you have an infertility problem? Because as we've said before, you know, some folks can try, it just may take a little bit longer, right. But how do you know that there might be an issue?
So usually the definition is based on age. So if you're over age 35, it's 6 months of trying and not having a successful pregnancy outcome. If you're under age 35, it's a year of trying and not having a successful outcome, because within a year's time, you should have conceived typically at that point. Now, other reasons in terms of medical history might be if you have recurrent miscarriage. So women that have more than two pregnancy losses, there's a very particular evaluation that goes along with that, which if you find something that's causing the miscarriages, there's potential treatment to increase live birth. Women that have very irregular menstrual cycles, so if they're going months without getting cycles or they stop having cycles altogether, or in women or men that are at risk for future fertility issues, so patients that are going through cancer treatments need to be seen to potentially talk about fertility preservation options like egg or embryo freezing.
So certainly some medical things we have to take into case, but like you said, even just your age, certainly a factor.
Correct.
When it comes to your fertility. Dr. Zimon, are there any sort of new technology at the center, anything that can increase the success rate?
Yes, there's so much. I mean, reproductive advances in this field of medicine are moving ahead so quickly, and we have the technology not only to test embryos, but to grow them better than we've ever been able to select the right ones.
Really?
We have something called an embryoscope where you can actually watch the embryo grow and learn so much about what makes the best embryo that's going to result in a pregnancy.
Wow.
And yeah, it's really amazing, and we can freeze embryos better than we've ever been able to. So we can store them indefinitely for women who are couples who wish to use it at a later time, or eggs. You know, for women who want to preserve their fertility, they can freeze their eggs, or for women who want to use someone else's eggs. We have this technique called vitrification, which is a high efficiency method of freezing eggs or embryos to return healthy pregnancies in the future.
A lot of options
there
then.
A lot of options, yeah.
Now, for those who are out there and they're saying, this sounds like me, we're trying to get pregnant and it's just not happening. Do you have any advice for them?
Yes, I mean, it is, it's common. That's the one thing, to know that you're not alone, and to also know that there's a lot of support. There's support in alternative therapies and counseling, but obviously there's medical support. And so doctors like Dr. Luzzo and I, it may be something that's very easy to solve, it may be something more challenging, but just come and see us. You may not have to go on and do in vitro fertilization. If that scares you, there may be something else you can do, or you may choose to embark on something very high tech and innovative like IVF or pre-implantation genetic testing. But the best thing to do is to empower yourself by learning more about it and either seeing a specialist or learning more about it online. A lot of things can be done to help you.
Seeing one of you too, I'm sure, will
help
a lot as
well.
If you'd like to learn more about IVF New England and the Providence Fertility Center, we'll post a link to their website on roadshow.com.